And joining us now via Skype from New York is the National Chair of the U.S. Pinoys for Good Governance, Loida Nicolas Lewis. And joining us here at the ABS-CBN International Headquarters is Rodel Rodis, President of the U.S. Pinoys for Good Governance. Thank you for joining us here on Balitang America.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The race for the Philippine presidency gets more crowded and really more interesting with the addition of Senator Grace Poe. She has topped the polls, but will it translate to actual votes? Simulan natin kay Loida. May laban ba si Grace? Suportado mo ba siya?
It is. Polls are very deceiving because in 2010, 8 months to go, Marrojas was 45%, Binay was down. But 8 months later, Binay won. Even in the FPJ and GMA 2004, FPJ was up 8 months before, GMA was down. At the end, GMA won. So we cannot really tell whether these polls will translate into the actual vote on election day.
Pero ikaw ba eh maka Grace po o maka Marrojas o maka Jejomar Binay? Sinong susuportahan mo?
Yeah, I've always been for Marrojas from
All right.
The beginning.
Hindi nagbabago yan.
Alam niya ni Jojo because we're classmates and he knows that.
All right. Rodel, ano naman ang sa tingin mo? Does Grace Poe have a winning chance, especially among overseas absentee voters?
Well, I think she, if the polls are to be followed, she has a chance. My concern is that whether the votes that go for her or for Marrojas will actually be counted because the Comelec Pecos machines have been given to China to manufacture. There are 10,000 voting machines, according to what I read, and China is very adept and technologically proficient in being able to manipulate the and hack into the machines. So my concern is that the votes will not be translated. Right now,
And the votes would go to whom?
Well, the votes would go to the Manchurian candidate, which is Binay, who has supported China's position of withdrawing from the International Tribunal of the Law of the Sea. Binay has actively said he will support bilateral negotiations, which means giving China undisputable sovereignty over the West Philippine Sea. Mm-hmm. One of the things I just want to say is that Grace Poe is the only senator to come out, the only presidential candidate to come out against China. She said that the West Philippine Sea belongs to us. I have yet to hear from Marrojas what mm-hmm. his position is. I spoke with Senate President Drilon in June asking him, what is Marrojas' position on the West Philippine Sea? And he said he would get back to me. It's been more than 3 months, and we have not heard one word from Marrojas
about the West Philippine Sea. So you are definitely supporting Grace Poe in this presidential race?
Well, right now, unless I hear something good from Marrojas, I will go with whoever is going to defend the Philippine sovereignty in the West Philippine Sea.
All right. Now, we all know that this presidential race is shaping to be a three-cornered fight among Poe, Marrojas, and Jejomar Binay. Some analysts are saying Binay might end up the winner because Poe and Rojas did not give way to each other. Mahati daw yung boto. Loida, what do you say about that?
I think may kamalian yan because Binay has a lot of support in the low, you know, B, C, D. Mm-hmm. And so with Grace Poe because of, you know, her name, her father, and her acceptability. Therefore, the votes that she will gain will be also coming from Binay votes. Mm-hmm. So it's really a three-corner flight. Let's not give it to, let's not say, maglalaban lang ang boto para kay
okay.
Marrojas at Grace.
All right. And finally, Rodel, your thoughts about this?
Well, again, if the votes are to be counted, I'm confident either Marrojas or Grace Poe will easily defeat Jojo Binay. As the poll shows, he's at 0%. The problem is whether China will allow the votes to be actually tabulated. I do believe there is a serious concern that China will manipulate the votes of the Comelec so that their candidate, Binay, will win.
All right. We'll see what the government will do about that. Thank you very much for joining us here on Balitang America. Loida Nicolas Lewis
Thank
and Rodel Rodis of the U.S. Pinoys for Good Governance. Mabuhay kayo.
Salamat.